Is it possible that spiritual entities are communicating with you and that these communications are being interpreted by you as your very own thoughts? The answer is yes. Not only yes, an emphatic yes. It happens all the time. So on this episode of Simply Stated, we're going to talk about how it happens, why it happens, and what you can do about it. Hey, welcome back to Simply Stated. It's been a couple weeks since I made a video. I thought I was going to make some while I was out of town visiting some family, but it just didn't work out. So anyway, let's get right into it. Is it possible that spiritual entities are communicating with you and that you're interpreting these communications as your own thoughts? And as I said in the intro, absolutely yes. And this is one of the most important things as an individual, not just Christians, but as an individual, to understand. And it's probably one of the least talked about things. In fact, I've been to literally dozens of church meetings and maybe heard about this mentioned twice in my life. So it's not talked about very often, and I think it is very important for you to understand who's communicating with you. So let's get some groundwork kind of laid out so that we understand what we're talking about. Today, I want to just focus on spiritual entities. Although there's other entities communicating with you, and a good example is subliminal. If you watch TV, if you listen to radio, if you look at newsprint, you are being communicated with, even though everybody's familiar with the concept of subliminal communication, it's not on the forefront of our mind, and we don't think about it, but it's very effective. Very effective. In fact, I've seen whole audiences of people draw the exact same picture on a piece of paper because a mentalist subtly influenced their thinking. So subliminal is very powerful, but that's not really what I want to talk about. Although it is an example of being communicated to and you just interpret it as your own thoughts. Today, I want to talk about spiritual entities communicating. Spiritual entities, I'm talking about primarily the Spirit of God, i.e. the Holy Spirit, or the enemy. A demonic entity. So there are three thoughts going on in your head, or three voices in your head that you'll hear, and that is yourself, possibly a demonic entity, or the Holy Ghost. So both the Holy Ghost and demonic entities can communicate with people in several different ways. They can speak to you actually audibly. You can hear it with your ears, or come to you in some kind of vision or some way that you're perceiving them with your eyes. But unquestionably, the most common way is spirit-to-spirit communication. And so before we get into that, let me kind of explain how humans are created. You are a spirit, and that is you're a spiritual being. That part of you is eternal. You also have a soul. And the soul, most people would describe it as your mind, your will, and your emotions. It's what makes up your personality. It's the things that you think about in your head and stuff like that. And lastly, we inhabit a body. Very temporal, as we know, they get sick, they break, they die. Your soul and your spirit, however, are eternal. They will go on. Somewhere, somehow, they go on. So when you're walking around day to day, you have your own thoughts. They're in your head. You hear them in your soul, I guess. If that's your mind, will, and your emotions, you have your thoughts in your soul. When the Holy Ghost wants to speak to you, or the enemy for that matter, they interface with your spirit, because their spirit, they interface with your spirit, and their communication sounds exactly like your own thoughts, because they are originating in your spirit. They speak it, it goes into your spirit, and your soul interprets it as your thought. And so both of these entities, a lot of people think God never talks to me, or they don't really think about the devil speaking to them. When I say devil too, it's just a generic term for any evil spirit, a demon. I'm not suggesting, although it may happen, that Lucifer, the Prince of Darkness, is speaking to you directly. He's not like God. He's not omnipotent. So, but there are untold numbers of demonic spirits that can influence you and talk to you. And so, as I said, when they communicate with you, they interface with your spirit, and their communications comes across as thoughts. It happens all the time. Let me give you a real common example. Happens to me all the time. You're walking around, you see somebody, and a thought pops into your head. Typically with me, it's some kind of judgmental thought. Wow, that person is really out of shape. You know, they should blah, 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 blah. Or, well, that person's ugly. And I don't feel that way, and I don't think that way, and it catches me off guard. Like, why am I thinking that? That's not how I feel, or what I think, or you know, maybe it's a lustful thought towards a woman, and it catches me off, and it's odd and out of place, and it's not my thought. Now, over the years I've developed discernment so that I know now when those thoughts pop into my head, and I get that feeling, that I know right away, that's not my thought. I don't have to own that. Likewise, when the Holy Ghost talks, it generally comes across as, wow, a profound thought. Or it's sometimes even stuff you hadn't even thought of. Here's another example. I was, and this just happened the other day. I was trying to drain my pool, and I have a little power pump, and I could not get, I was priming it. I've done it for years. I could not get it to work. I actually took the pump into my shop to take it apart to figure out maybe there was something clogged in it or something. It just wasn't getting. And as I was walking back to kind of check the hoses, I thought, well, maybe the hoses are kinked or got a clog in them or something like that. The Holy Ghost spoke to me and said, put the pump much lower than you were putting it. In other words, so I have, it's a above ground pool. It's nothing fancy. It's a doughboy pool. And I had the pump sitting below it. So it was lower than the water level, but the Holy Ghost told me, take it and move it 30 feet down. And it's kind of sitting on a hill, so that, it's not rocket science, but there's some gravity involved and stuff like that. And sure enough, when I did it, and again, I've over the years become to discern what's my voice, what's the enemy's voice, and what's the Holy Ghost's voice. So I recognize the Holy Ghost speaking wisdom to me. And I was like, oh, you know, and so when I did it, and bam, right away, that pump just fired up and began spitting water wholesale fashion out of my pool. And then I was like, ah, thank you, Holy Ghost. And that's one example of how that works. Now in the Bible, 2 Corinthians, Paul admonishes us to take every thought captive to the obedience of Christ. And so when I was a young Christian, I didn't know what that meant. But what that means is not every thought that you have is your thought. But if you own it, if you think it's your thought and you own it, you will begin to develop a warped sense of who you are, especially if a lot of what you're hearing is the enemy's chatter. Because the enemy will put thoughts into your head of you're a wicked person, you're a mean person, look at how despicable you are, how you judge other people, how you crave despicable, debaucherous things with people, whatever the case may be. Because you're interpreting that as your thought, you begin to own that. You begin to go, wow, I really am this person, maybe. You know what I mean? Something that a lot of people don't know is God is always speaking to you. The biggest problem to hearing God's voice is we are so busy in the world being entertained. To sit still is murderous for a lot of people. Just to sit still and be quiet. The noise of life will drown out the voice of God. Or if you just are walking around and every thought you have you own, you won't know when God's speaking to you and or when the enemy's speaking to you. So let's bring this all home. When you have a thought that seems out of character for you, you can begin, and the more you do this, the better you'll get at it. You can begin to just go, whoa, that's not, you question every thought. And I have to do that all the time. Just because I've developed a little more discernment about what's my thought, what's the enemy's thought, what's the Holy Ghost talking to me. My wife goes nuts because we'll be having a talk and she'll tell me something and I don't answer right away. I have to think about, you know, when someone's talking to you, obviously you're having thoughts right away, especially into a deep discussion. And I sit there and I need to process it and weigh the things that my mind is thinking to discern, is this my thought? Is this the Holy Ghost thought? Am I getting reactionary thoughts? Or is the enemy shooting things in there just to say hurtful things or something like that? So I spend a lot of time, especially in a discussion, weighing what thoughts are going through my head. And it helps. And so if you can begin to realize that all this noise in your life, anxiety, stress, just busyness, entertainment, creates a chatter and a noise that drowns out the Holy Ghost. If you can begin to get yourself into a calm place, you'll begin to recognize that, oh wow, the Holy Ghost is speaking to me. And the things he has to say are great. The Bible says that the Holy Ghost is there to lead us into all truth. All truth. And that doesn't just specifically mean Bible truth. He'll lead you into all truth. Truth is truth, and all truth is God's truth. But the Holy Ghost will lead you into things that are true and give you insight into things that you don't understand. And that's maybe a topic for another video, but it's something to look forward to once you begin to discern what's God's voice and you give Him room to speak into your life. He's always talking, but once you discern His voice, you'll begin to have communication, back and forth conversation, once you are able to understand that the Holy Ghost has been communicating with you, you just weren't understanding it was Him. And conversely, you can now reject thoughts that you recognize are not your thoughts. One time I heard a quote from Curry Blake that he attributed to, I want to say, Kenneth Hagin. I could be wrong on that one, but that's what I think was the originator. And it is, you can't stop a bird from flying over your head, but you can keep it from building a nest in your hair. And I thought that was a really good picture analogy of, there's thoughts going on that you don't have to own, because they're not necessarily your thoughts. But if you accept them as your thoughts, they will make a home in your head and begin to do damage. So, moving forward, know that you don't have to own every thought that pops into your head. You can decide which thoughts are yours, which thoughts are God's, and which thoughts are the enemy's. So I hope this begins to help. I know that it's blessed me immensely, so be blessed.